A word for our listeners. Season 2 of Masks of Nyarlathotep is set in the 1930s and 40s. We will be using terms and sayings from those times, including some that could be considered offensive. It's not our intention to offend. We merely wish to offer as accurate a view of the time period as possible. Welcome to Masks of Nyarlathotep, a Nerd's Domain gaming podcast. Join us each week as our commandos uncover the corruption of the mythos in World War II. Starring Johnny Brown, Ed Maudlin, Chris Dunn, and Matt Quiet, with John Quiet running the table as keeper. Eldritch evils and crazed Nazi cultists await you just beyond this music. Hey everybody, and welcome back to the Nerds Domain Presents Masks of Nyarlathotep. I'm Matt, and I'm here with John.
Hello.
Cullen.
The hell?
Ed.
What's up?
And Rob.
Hello.
And we are back after a short hiatus on our end where some of us went out of country, or out of state.
Florida's like another country.
Look, I went to 12 countries in one day.
Out of body experiences.
You went to another world.
A whole new world.
Did you close your eyes?
I can't.
Don't you dare close your eyes.
Careful. We're verging on lawsuit territory here.
Okay. So we took a hiatus. So, John, you're going to tell us where we were at so that we remember. I know we just listened to it, but I don't think we were paying attention. We were just laughing at stupid stuff. And so, there was a lot of that.
Yep, there was. So our four intrepid, silent, but well, I guess three silent but deadly commandos,
and
their
Colin.
new former SOE operative, were traipsing through the German woods in search of a numbers station that was broadcasting a strange message.
Were we traipsing? Is that what we were doing?
Well, I mean, there
traipsing
were
doesn't sound military.
Yeah, none of us are French.
Yeah.
No, not
take
I guess
that,
not
France.
Anymore.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure the French
isn't Levon.
I'm Italian.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
I tell by the slice.
Italian
of
French. What's the difference?
You can tell by the slice of pizza I always keep in my back pocket.
Yeah, yeah, and the salami.
Mm-hmm.
This is
that one's in the front.
This is making me so uncomfortable.
I'm glad that I could set that up for you, and then you could just take off with
oh,
it.
Oh yeah,
I appreciate that.
That was a low ball. It was easy. It's nothing.
So yeah, the Silent but Deadly Commandos and a few NPCs, a total of a party of eight.
Can we talk
this
about
point in time?
Go ahead. Yeah,
I thought it was
but the two NPCs are back at camp, right? Cecil and Herman.
You sent them back to camp.
I have them crossed off on my list after conferring with our commander.
Okay. We sent them back with the location of the number station.
Ah, yes.
Yeah, because we were concerned that something stupid might happen. Why would we ever do that?
Speaking of which, we still have the grenades.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. We haven't fired a shot, period, don't think.
Can we quickly talk about Cullen's octopus shirt?
Yeah.
Why?
What's going on there?
It's a sharp shirt. I bought it at Old Navy.
Oh, okay.
And,
you've explained all your bad choices.
I thought since we were playing Cthulhu, there's tentacles.
You could have a fancy shirt like this.
The Nerds
Domain presents Masks of Nyarlathotep.
Nyarlathotep.
Mm-hmm. Promoting your podcast that you're on.
That no one can see because it's
a
podcast.
Actually, you can go straight over to tpublic.com/user/nerdsdomain and purchase them there. There you go.
Nice
you
plug.
Like that?
Yeah.
Nice plug. And as I'm looking at your shirt, I'm realizing I'm still not spelling Nyarlathotep.
I'm
not doing this anymore.
I'm
going to keep screwing it up. And
when
just,
you,
the
problem, Ed, is when you get it right, then he's got his hooks in you.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
you're
yeah.
Gone.
Yeah,
so
right,
exactly.
You want to keep misspelling it because it means he hasn't gotten you yet.
Yeah, exactly.
Stay strong. Yeah. Yeah.
Nyarlathotep is one of the easier ones to pronounce.
Hooray.
I don't know.
Okay, that's cool.
There are some of those really racist ones that are kind of easy.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, well, those are hard to pronounce for other reasons.
Yeah.
There are no hyphens or apostrophes here.
Yeah. Okay, all right.
Or, you know, three consonants in a row.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, what was the word that we were mispronouncing?
You were mispronouncing.
Yeah, when I say we, I mean the royal we.
Sabotage.
Sabotage.
It wasn't sabotage. It was something else.
But yeah, sabotage came. If one of the listeners wants to remind us, what
I don't know that
was.
That was this. I think that was D&D.
Was that? Oh, was that? That wasn't even.
that wasn't even a recording. That was just you coming.
Okay,
over.
So if one of the voices in my head wants to tell us what that word was we were mispronouncing,
if the government's listening in, please.
Anybody from the NSA, just please let us know.
So, John.
Right. So you guys were in the woods. You had found the number station. You were attempting to capture a truck that was leaving the number station to figure out what was going on inside.
I think also then to ride the truck inside.
Right, and, yeah. You were going to drive it out and come back in.
And crowd horse it in.
Yeah.
What? Is that not a thing? Crowd horse?
I don't know. I'm not.
It sounds delicious.
I thought that's
I'm thinking like, you know, horse stuffed with sauerkraut. I mean,
I was thinking that's how you raised money for farm animals. Crowd horsing.
Oh, that's terrible.
Wow.
I like it.
That's so much worse. That's a bad joke, and you should be ashamed of yourself.
It's the worst. The worst.
The worst.
You little brat.
Oh, my God. Where are we? What is happening?
So, John, you were saying.
I don't remember anymore.
We were going to capture
a truck. But after some failed rolls, you got away.
That's right.
I got better dice now, I hope.
It was a night of failed rolls. I like that you have balls, as though they're going to stop on a number.
They will. They happen. It works.
So anyway, they got the truck got away, but then in it surprised you when three soldiers appeared Captain Loveridge when three soldiers appeared out of nowhere.
I'm Captain Loveridge.
Oh, you're Loveridge. You're
Mackenzie.
Mackenzie
was scouting, trying to see if the truck was coming back. When three soldiers appeared out of nowhere.
Kind of Stargate style?
Yeah, very, very much so, yeah. So there was a mobile command center had been set up on the road. The truck vanished as it tried to pass the barricade, and that's where the soldiers appeared, was on your side of the barricade. So the disappearing is happening on your end, not on their end.
Okay.
It was clear that whatever was outside that line was not interacting with anything inside the line.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just thinking Nazi Stargate's going to be like the worst thing that could ever happen.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Nazis across space. Like, nobody wants that.
I think there's an episode out there about that, I think.
Of Stargate?
Maybe.
I didn't watch much.
I'm confusing it with...
Jews in space?
No.
If there's a sci-fi show at some point... They're going to come across space Nazis. That's just the fact.
Enterprise did it, where the lizard people were helping the Nazis.
Oh, right. Yeah.
Wait a minute. Like, I thought that actually happened, that the lizard people were helping the Nazis. That was just an episode of Star Trek?
Calm down, Connie.
Hold on. Man, I need to go back and look at my high school history books.
So there was a plan that involved your wing commander, Reese Llewellyn, stripping down to his underwear, covering himself in blood as a distraction.
Or Tuesday.
How you do?
Tuesday, yeah. Like he calls it.
Yep.
We call it a distraction.
And
I was distracted.
That was how the discussion, the plan was. You know what you usually do on Tuesday? I know it's Thursday, but just hear me out.
So you guys rushed out and captured yourself three Nazi soldiers.
One of which who has been hit in the face with a...
Yes, one is currently recovering.
I thought you hit him in the back of the head.
No. There was a whole argument. We just listened to it.
Right, but...
I hit him in the face.
Because
somebody didn't want me to kill him. I didn't want to kill him. Also, I kind of wanted to kill him.
Facing rules.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah, I did want to kill him.
Yeah.
Well, the night's still young.
So, Evan, you've marched your two uninjured prisoners back into the woods and dragged the, you know, injured one off. So that's where we're going to open up. The six British operatives standing over three Nazis.
Okay.
One of which is bloody nose, and they're standing there. They're, you know, got their arms, their hands behind their head. They're captured. They're waiting to hear what you guys have to ask them.
And we're not in military uniform. Is that correct?
You guys, I believe, were.
Well,
in...
Well, I mean, I know what the commander's wearing.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, it's starting to get a little chilly. But
I've got my robe and heels in the grass. I'm fine.
We'll get to them in a minute.
Being led by Klinger, apparently.
Yeah.
This is how Germany's whole culture, sex culture, evolves. It starts here with you. This is all your fault.
I'm a revolutionary.
Knocks something in his head into the right place. He's like, you know what? I'm going to pursue this from now on.
And he goes on to write Hedwig and the Angry Inch.
Started with bloody underwear. Go ahead, John. I'm sorry.
No, I'm waiting for you guys because you were going to interrogate the Nazis.
I'm going to just look intimidatingly at them.
Is that okay?
Yeah, who has the highest? That would be the commander.
Okay.
You or the commander are the talky people.
Okay.
I'm the shooty people.
Yeah.
So we're going to have the dude covered in blood go up to them and ask them questions.
Yeah. You know what? I'd be intimidated by that.
Sure.
I would be intimidated.
That's going to add something to it.
Yeah.
To my credit, I'm the dude naked, covered in blood with a very large assault rifle.
Sure. Yeah.
I don't know what's scarier. I don't know.
Wow. Not to sound like a typical American, but I don't think you have an assault rifle. I'm pretty sure you have a submachine gun.
Stop.
Let's not qualify that as an assault rifle.
Come on. All right, so what are we doing? We're yelling at these guys, asking them what the hell's going on, right?
Yeah.
Someone's got to ask them.
Yeah, you speak German, right?
Yes, I do.
Okay, thank God.
So I think I do, but I think you're better at it.
I actually speak German better than I speak English at this point.
Yeah, so you should.
Typical Welsh. Go ahead.
So first we'll start with some basic questions, get their name, rank, and position in the army.
Okay. They are, and again, this is where I remind our listeners that I am not a historian and not at all involved with the military, so I don't know how this would work, but they are basically corporals, lowest rank grunts of the Nazi military.
And to any of our listeners who are uptight about any historical inaccuracies, please remember that we have an attorney who is a wolf fish man.
Also,
kind of send letters to his office.
Yeah.
Also, this isn't a documentary.
Yeah. Oh, it's not. No, that's true. That is not.
Are you saying this didn't actually happen?
Oh,
that technically speaking, you can't prove that it didn't.
I guess not. If you want to play that game,
you're right. And the simplest explanation is that we interrogated a bunch of German soldiers in the middle of a road while you were wearing bloody underwear.
Well, I think
we'll
drug
them
off
the road.
We're off the road.
After they traveled through dimension or time or whatever.
Yeah.
That was the problem we had with this.
I think that is the next question. What the bloody hell is the portal that they were traveling through?
The portal? They don't understand what you mean by that word.
Space hole? I don't know.
You have to bleep that out, right?
Pretty sure, yeah. Pretty sure. Well,
now you do.
All right, the aperture, the doorway?
Blank stares. They're trying to answer, but they don't understand the words.
Are these the same three guys we saw come through the first time?
Wait a minute.
And then go back?
They understand German, right? We're not just like...
Oh, yeah. No.
I was going to say, I'm speaking German.
I just want to make sure that wasn't the barrier we could get past. Okay.
I just rolled a six for my German.
That's good.
Yeah. Can I just go ahead and jump in and ask a question?
Sure.
Where did you guys come from?
Well, when a mommy Dusseldorf. Nazi and a daddy Nazi.
Love each other very much.
Hate everything else very much.
Yeah.
And they want to make sure to strengthen the Reich.
They arrived here a week ago with the mobile camp, Mackenzie noted, and were like trying to their mission, as far as they understood it, was to figure out what the weirdness going on at the laboratory is or was, and. they were ordered to follow the truck across the truck that appeared in front of their barricade. Their commander told them to, you know, chase it down and try to get it to stop. They crossed the line, tried to get to the truck, and, you know, they've spent a week wandering around in the woods. So they were ordered to chase down the truck. They crossed the barricade. They approached the laboratory, the secret broadcast tower. Mm-hmm. Interacted with the people there, told them that they had been sending out the same message for about a month, and they were, you know, that was weird because they were expecting different messages to come out every so often. But when they attempted to return to their mobile encampment, they just appeared back on the road. As though crossing the line turned them around and their momentum took them back, was trying to take them back to the secret base.
So like a full 90-degree
yes.
turn?
So they walked through something and didn't realize it, and they were looking a different
yes.
direction. Okay.
I didn't know if it was Pac-Man rules.
Right. So that was going on, or so that happened.
Guys don't know anything.
They went back to the base, told them what was going on. They basically were given barracks up on the surface level, and they've been wandering around ever since. They were basically working on the camp ever since. They've made several attempts to leave, but they can't. And then just today for them, they were at the camp doing whatever orders they had been, you know, whatever work they had been given, and then suddenly they appeared again on the road chasing the truck. And then you guys captured them.
Okay. How many levels are underground at the base?
They have no idea. They went.
But there are levels underground.
Oh, yeah. There's definitely an elevator shaft in there.
Are they standard German army? Okay. They're not SS or...
No. Although you are seeing... Well, you're not seeing them, but there are SS...
Yeah, we saw those at the number station. At the,
mm-hmm. Well, also outside.
Oh, okay.
Where they can't get to.
Okay. How many men are at the number station?
I probably gave that number to you last time.
You gave us a count?
I gave an estimate.
Yeah, does it match?
Their answer matches, yes.
Okay. Who's in charge?
They have, again, whatever rank, Mueller is
so
the
like
commanding
officer. So like a colonel?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's who they met, and that is who they were told is in charge.
I'm not the thinky and the talky guy.
Yeah.
No, I know. I'm just trying to think of, like, what would be a good question that would actually benefit
us. Unfortunately, I think we got all the information out of them that they have.
Because they don't know what's going on.
Yeah, they weren't, from the sounds of it, they weren't assigned to the listening station, right? They were told to come here.
No, they were assigned to the down the road people.
Yeah.
So someone might know what's going on with that road, but they don't know what the heck it is.
What's the timing on when they first came in until they appeared again here just now?
7 days.
Exactly 7 days?
Yeah.
Did they lose 7 days?
No, remember
okay.
doing everything for 7 days.
Okay.
And then appearing where they started, quote unquote, their 7 days.
Are we within the weird magnetic field here?
Oh, yes.
I think there's some kind of like rift in time something. And they don't even know what the heck it is.
Is there any of them that is about the same size as one of us?
Sure. How, what's everybody's size?
Mine's a 10.
I'm a 12.
13.
I forget where that is written.
Say 11. Say 11. It's very top left.
10.
Top left.
Strength, condition, size.
Oh, yes, 10.
Not condition.
Constitution. Thank you. So we almost had a 10.
You're the biggest.
I'm a big dude. Apparently. All right.
Yeah. It's not his fault. He's the biggest and the strongest.
He doesn't even exercise.
I'm going to have Haley and Morley keep watch these. We're going to talk. And I want to walk off so we can still see them, but we can talk without them hearing us.
Sure.
And I'll motion for the rest of you to come like that. I just wander off. Like, you two, watch them. And I'll walk off.
Just talking to a tree.
So I think that perhaps our best option is we send the two of these guys in with one of these guys in with two of us, or somebody goes into the German camp with them. Procure Nazi uniforms, bring them back out. We all dress up. We all give the same story. We then investigate the camp from inside the camp.
I don't think we take any of them with us. I say we just put on uniforms and go.
I think so, because of...
And we bring naked bloody guy along.
If we... Well, yeah, that we got a hostage.
We've captured an enemy combatant.
I'm not against that idea.
I kind of am, because we haven't officially invaded yet, have we?
That we are at war. The Germans have declared war.
I am.
We're in March, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't want to get bogged down in historical details. Let's go. Let's go blow some stuff out.
Battle of Britain is technically started. It's not heavy by any means, but there have been naval battles. Yeah, they were at war.
So we in it.
Yeah. So I don't. What do we do with these three while we four, I assume, go? I'm not against killing them and leaving their bodies in the woods, but I want to make sure that that's a conscious decision and not just a hasty one.
Right.
Yeah.
Well,
I don't want to leave two guys guarding three guys.
Yeah. Right. Even if they're tied up or whatever.
Right. Right. I mean, we could morphine them up so much that they wouldn't be able to do much.
Do we have morphine on us?
No.
It's almost standard in field packs. Like, everybody has morphine.
Really?
Yeah. You carry at least two vials of it so that if you get hurt, the medic doesn't have to carry all this morphine with them. He just takes yours and uses it on you.
Okay.
I watched Band of Brothers. Taught me a lot.
All right.
Yeah.
At least that's how the Americans do it. I assume the Britons would do, British would do it too. I don't know. Maybe not.
I think we should have a little more confidence in our knot tying ability if we're not going to kill them.
See, the thing is that we don't have morphine. We just have tea bags full of opium.
Oh, that's that makes sense. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Totally.
Right. Right. Never mind. So we just teabag them. So
suck on my bag.
Hit him with your salami.
You just keep giving me these really good audio clips.
You're welcome. I might not be good at the game, but I'm really helpful for the Patreon. So.
Okay. So you think we just tie him? You, Jack? You think tying him up here is a good?
I'm good with tying him up. I don't have a whole lot of compunction about just, you know, killing them and throwing them in the ditch.
I don't have a problem with that either. I'm concerned that there may be something worthwhile that we could still wring out of them later.
We can... all right.
I mean, if we're just going to kill them, like, let's get it done.
The only problem with that is we need to find a way to kill them quietly.
I will pull off my shovel and extend it out so that it's ready.
I'm pretty sure there's a good, hefty hunk of... stick around here, I can
a rock
use.
Or something.
Yeah.
I mean, we can handle this. We just have to make sure that the other guy that we do it all at once, so that one guy doesn't freak and start causing a ruckus.
Mm-hmm.
I assume
mm-hmm.
we strip them of weapons, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
You did notice that their weapons are empty. They don't have any bullets in their guns.
Okay, and they're just like regular guns. They're not like space guns or anything like that.
They are
okay.
Standard issue.
That would be Nazi space guns.
Sure. I apologize.
Spotsy guns.
Spotsy guns, sure. Because who has time to say space Nazis?
So what do you think, Commander? Do we kill them? Do we tie them up?
They're enemy combatants. I'm fine killing them.
Well, I mean, if okay, mm-hmm. All right, sure.
I mean, they're Nazis. Maybe I'm just like feeling particularly salty about Nazis.
Mm-hmm. My
in 21st century America, but yeah,
my father taught me that even when you have a tool that you don't necessarily need right now, doesn't mm-hmm. mean you just burn it when you could use it later.
Yeah, but do most of his tools like jump out of the cabinet and kill him in his sleep?
Look, I'm just saying, I don't want to kill
like,
him.
If I had a hammer that would jump out, like crawl out of my garage and into my house and start banging me on the foot, I'd probably burn that hammer.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm not disagreeing with killing them. I'm just saying it's a matter of when.
Okay, sure.
We should probably remove their uniforms first.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. We don't want to get blood on them.
Yeah. Or holes in them if we're going to wear them.
Right.
Yeah. But, we do not have nearly enough club soda in our packs to clean those.
No.
Should we check to see if there's any kind of special thing we need to do when we're walking into the radio place? Or
we just pretend like we don't know what's going on.
Sounds good.
I mean,
like we just got sent from the mobile camp to check on what's happening.
I think that the commander needs to be in a uniform, though. He is both good at talking and actually speaks decent German.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, my character is fluent in German.
I'm a 30 in German.
I'm a 30 in German as well.
I'm a 30 in German.
Hi. Okay.
Oh, so we all suck.
Okay, cool. So which one of us is wearing the bloody underwear?
I'll just wear it under my uniform.
Okay. All right.
I'm not going to wear Nazi breeches.
Well, it's just that there's only three uniforms, so we got to figure out who wears what.
Yeah. Which is my new favorite insult.
My physical form is notable, so perhaps I should be the one to be the prisoner.
Okay. You're referring to your facial scars.
Yes. I have a milky eye.
Yes.
Oh, right, right. You I'm like, what? You're like beefcake or what? And yeah, okay.
Yeah, I'm just
I'm
a tall
so
guy.
Hot.
Yeah.
It's the fire burns.
Sure, sure.
Yeah.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah.
I would say the three. Will the three uniforms that we have fit the three of them? A 12, a 13, and a 10?
It'll fit two of you.
I'm a 12 extra long, so
yeah. Almost a 13.
Almost a 13. Yeah.
So yeah, we'll make you can make it work.
Okay. Okay.
It probably wouldn't pass like military parade inspection, but I don't think standard uniform issues, you know, were checked like that at every day. So.
The guns they have, do we have any ammunition that'll work in them?
I'm not up on the gun stuff, so I don't know.
There's a chart.
Cool.
I should have thought about that before I asked.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? I don't think the German weapons are in here. We'll find out. This will be fun.
Yeah,
because we can't go walking in there with our guns. We have to use theirs to blend in, right?
Yeah, and I'm pretty sure they're going to be using 9mm and 9mm Kurtz.
I'm also going to just throw out there that they're not going to expect you to shoot anything when you're on your own home base.
Right.
Base.
I'm just saying if something gets hairy, that's
sure,
all I'm talking about.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm not going to go in there dressed as a Nazi and just start shooting everyone. Yeah. It's going to blow the cover real quick.
Oh, was that not the plan?
No, we throw grenades first.
Yeah. Slash and burn.
Look at these guys not planning on shooting anything.
Right. Right? Wow.
I'm planning on not getting shot. That's what I'm planning
okay.
on.
Okay.
Sometimes
things don't go according to plan, all right?
Well, that's why I was asking about the weapons, just in case.
I just wanted to make sure you weren't, like, worried that they were going to inspect your weapons and not find bullets or something.
Right. Yeah, that's not a...
That's not a thing that's going
to
happen.
I'm just assuming the plan is going to fall apart because, what was it, no plan survives first contact with the enemy?
Right. I'm going to guess that the rifles do not use the same. It doesn't say. I could dig into this deeper if you really want me to.
I'm not concerned either way. But you want to have.
Oh, I'm going to have them break down my machine gun and put it in a pack.
Okay.
That way you guys can carry it in while I'm under guard.
Mm-hmm. I will carry one of the rifles from the people, but I'm going to keep my pistol on me.
Okay. That makes sense. You're going to break down the larger guns so and hide them.
Or we could just carry them like we took them off of him.
Yeah.
Well, yes.
Yeah.
Look at these three Tommy guns this guy was carrying.
I mean,
we could carry one like that, probably.
Sure, yeah, sure, that makes sense.
Yeah, one, so break one down, carry one Tommy gun. And then
was that all the Tommy guns?
No, I have one.
So
I
have I've got a pistol and a Sten, is that right? How you pronounce
yeah.
it?
Yeah. yeah. So there was three. An Italian yeah. machine gun.
I have
yeah,
my...
So
I,
I'll carry my pistol and I'll break down the a machine gun.
Sure.
I mean, I guess I've got all of these, don't I? The yeah. Enfield, the 1911, and the Thompson?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. yeah. So.
So, yeah. I'm the one who's armed to the teeth.
Okay.
We could also, like, say we found him and he's the only survivor. We took out his group and this is the mm-hmm. stuff they had on them.
That's our story. Yeah.
No. But, I'll just, I mean, you're talking amongst yourselves. You have a spatial awareness of where the barrier seems to be
because yeah.
mm-hmm. you've crossed it and seen the other side of it. So assuming it is relatively circular in its shape, any gunfire would probably carry pretty well, and they would have at least, like the guards at the gate would have at least heard little
yeah.
pop
yeah.
pop pops of actual gunfire.
Right.
So telling them that you killed a bunch of dudes with guns would not
unless we fire off a bunch of shots.
Well, maybe we could just go pop pop pop.
I mean, you can't. I'm just, yeah.
That could
Skinny standing out. Bang! Bang, bang!
If we do that, that could, like, alert them to where we are, and they it's come true. Down, and yeah. then they find the guys who got bound up, so.
We'll just I mean, play.
You do
well,
have
just
three
keep drawing
people
them out
to kill.
One at a time.
yeah.
You do have three people to kill. I'm just, you could shoot them.
Yeah.
If
That's
you want.
True.
I'm just.
I'm also just happy carrying sidearms into this. Let's try not to destroy everything.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, that's just. Backup stuff. Yeah.
yeah. Wait. Oh. Oh. Okay. You mean not destroy everything at the base?
Not yet.
Right.
We this is recon.
Hey, Captain.
Yeah. We got to figure out what the heck it is before we do anything with it.
Remember that time when we were saying, "Gosh, we should have brought more grenades." Remember that time?
Yeah.
That was a great time, wasn't it? Yeah. That was fun.
I only have
not
six.
Having enough grenades.
I only have six.
Yeah. That
only.
Was a lot of fun.
We will. Mm-hmm.
I mean, this base that you're trying to sneak into is, you know, fairly well, you know, stocked. Like, they might have explosives you
so
can,
we can
steal.
Just, yeah.
So we can just pick. So we can pick some up on the way.
Yeah.
Is what
oh,
you're
exactly.
I'm going to bring my grenades and my satchel charge just in case.
I'm saying it's possible.
Okay. So I think we go in.
Yeah.
With that plan in mind.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. Rather than BYOG, we're just going to presume that we.
Sure.
Yeah. Okay. That the party will have grenades.
That they will have grenades.
Right.
So you're leaving Marley or Morley and.
Haley.
The other
Haley.
One.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, they didn't spend 6 weeks in basic training to be called the other one. They got names.
And all the rest.
With the professor and Marianne at the side of the road. So I think first we need to kill these Nazis.
Okay.
Okay.
Are you just going to let us do that, or do we need to roll?
I mean, if you, like,
is
what
that part of the plan that we say
that
we?
To
I'm going to hit mine over and over with an entrenching tool until he stops moving.
Let's say.
Oh, so we're going to beat him to death. Okay.
Well, no. Entrenching tool has a very solid like.
Okay.
It's almost an axe.
Yeah.
So we're not going with the story that we found this guy and shot the other guys.
No.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
Yeah.
I would say that we have them strip first.
Uh huh.
Mm-hmm.
And then. Murder them, and then remove
no,
the enemy
no, 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 no.
Combatants.
We're at war. This is it's not murder if you're at war.
Sure.
Right.
Yeah. Then
execute the enemy combatants.
Sure.
All right.
So what?
Whatever allows us to sleep at night. You know.
Enjoy
so
your nightmares.
So I would like you guys to. So you walk back to Morley and Haley,
mm-hmm.
and wave them, tell them, you know, make them step back.
Mm-hmm.
And then what do you say to the three Nazi prisoners?
Auf Wiedersehen.
Oh, jeez.
You know what? That's I see where you're going here.
Do you?
They're not just going to take off their clothes willingly. How about instead we tell them that we're going to question them individually, one at
a
time, away. So we have that guy go off.
Okay.
Then have him strip. It's easier to strip one dude rather than three. Then beat him to death. Then come back and be like, "Your turn. Come with us."
What was all that noise in the bush?
Where was where's Hans?
Hans is he's.
Resting. We let him go.
Yeah. Answer our questions. We let you go.
Yeah,
one at a time. safer that way.
So that's the plan.
I don't know. Whatever. That's a terrible explanation.
That really is
a
terrible
back end.
Yeah.
So how do we get them out of the uniforms? That's that. Yeah. Look, all my plans end up with somebody naked. So far.
What's I'm the fastest thing that we can do so we can get to the actual radio tower? Whatever that is what I'm in favor of.
Could just okay, all right. Here's what we do. We need to wrap their uniforms in plastic.
Like a Gallagher show.
Like a Gallagher show.
Then we get the giant mallet.
Chop their heads off.
Wow. I went
put a grenade in their mouth and just pull the pen. You're done.
Wow.
I've never discussed execution of prisoner methods this much.
I know.
During a game. Ever.
We could just go back to the rifle stock to the back of the head method.
Yeah, I guess we could just knock them out one at a time.
And then we could strip them
and hope for the best.
One at a time?
Right.
Well, okay.
On three.
Yep.
One.
Yep.
Two.
That's what we do. Yeah. And if we kill them, great. If we don't,
I need to know what's going to happen.
I think three of us walk up behind the guys, whack them in the back of the head.
Knock them out.
Yeah.
Knock them out or kill them.
Yeah, because if it doesn't kill them, it's going to leave them pretty freaking woozy. And then we just hit them again. We don't use anything bladed, and we try and keep the blood to a minimum.
All right.
Correct. I love this plan. I'm excited about this
plan.
Three
executioners to prepare to roll.
I got it.
I'm a 14 strength. I should probably be rolling.
No, you actually want to look at your close combat.
I want to look at my close combat.
It's going to be on the right-hand side in that column.
51.
Yeah. I'm sorry. 20. Not you, Colin. You're going to look at club. You're not a military character, so.
65.
Enjoy your death, gentlemen.
Don't tell them that.
By the way,
pardon me, you.
We don't make sanity checks for murdering people. You make sanity checks for watching us murder people. Yeah. FYI.
Well, then I'm not going to look.
Yeah, clearly, so, if I didn't see it, it didn't happen.
Bingo, Django.
Are you sure you're not an American?
I have some relatives across the pond.
So, your huddle of four.
You're Italian,
has decided,
right? Oh, this is. I mean, this is probably what you know. You and your uncle. Do.
Anyway, your huddle of four.
Spring break.
The four PCs.
Yeah.
Is still standing away.
Sure.
You've decided to club them to death.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like baby seals.
Like. They're
this
kneeling
is
with
so
their
twisted.
Hands behind
I love
their head.
It.
Sure.
So do you just walk up and club them?
Well, I want them to move their hands.
What does that mean?
No, okay. I think we
fine.
Have them stand up.
Okay.
And as they stand up, they're going to, you know, put their hands down.
Are you going to tell them to put
their
hands
down? Yeah,
stand
up, put your hands down, and then, like, we'll just, the three of us will be behind them and whack.
All right.
Sounds like a great plan, doesn't
it? It worked in your favor.
Yay!
I rolled an 80, and that seems too high for one of them to have gotten the idea that, oh, God, they're about to murder us.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Make your...
Execute.
I mean...
Yeah,
I start.
Semantics.
I keep starting to feel bad about this, and then just remember they're Nazis, and
yeah.
Fine.
Yeah,
I knew they were
all
right, Nazis.
So you guys all roll your close combat check.
Fail.
I got mine.
I barely failed mine. 57.
All right, so Svitz, who's in front of
Svitz.
Yeah, I don't know.
He's a sweaty guy.
Sure,
he really is.
Who's standing in front of Loveridge, goes down like a sack of potatoes.
Okay.
The other two just start screaming and take off running.
Oh, God.
Okay.
Can I catch one of them and
potentially
knock him in the back of the head?
Dexterity, opposed dexterity.
Sure, that's a thing. Sure. I got a 70. You got a 76.
I got a 76.
Yes. And then I'm gonna whack him in the back of the head.
Okay. One of them.
Yeah, that's one of them.
Uh-huh.
What's the other one?
Yeah, yeah.
What, anybody chasing the other one?
Yeah, I'm going after
my dexterity is 9.
My dexterity is 14.
Okay.
So you'll go.
Yeah. 47.
8.
Hey.
Ooh. Ooh, okay.
He's still running.
He's still running.
Yeah.
Okay.
You got up. You thought you had him, and, like, the rifle butt just, like, whiffed the back of his neck. He totally felt it.
At this point in the war, are the Italians and the Germans... allies?
Probably.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
However, the Italians, yeah. The Italians are not at war just yet.
Right.
But the Germans are.
All right.
Yeah, I don't think I can catch him, so I think I'm going to take a shot at the guy.
Hold on. Hold on. I pull out a knife and throw. I'm good at throwing.
Okay.
Okay.
Go for it.
Yes, I hit him.
Damage?
Looks like... six damage.
You get him in the back of the in the back. He's got a knife embedded in his shoulder blade. He stumbles. So somebody, McKenzie, would have another chance to catch up to him.
I will continue pursuit.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm we're trying not to fire at them.
Yeah, I know.
Give me roll under dex times two.
Under dex times two.
Or time what is two and five? Right, is five is average. Times two is hard.
That's on skills.
Right.
Because we're not on skills, no. It's just you assign a times whatever. Typically times five.
In the seventh edition or whatever, times five was considered.
Yes, but an seventh edition attempt. But
yeah.
Yeah, those are different rules though.
Okay.
Like yeah.
Well, I'm sticking with times two. Give me a roll. I'm trying to get under times two.
I'm gonna put my hand out and say, Worley. Knife. Morley, knife.
You need another knife?
I only have one.
Oh, man.
I have an entrenching tool. That's what I murder people with.
Throw the entrenching tool. All
right.
I have a knife, too, if you need a knife.
If somebody hands me a knife, I will throw that knife.
Okay. Throw.
Take one off one of the dead Germans.
Yeah, I hit. That is not a crit, though.
Okay.
It's close. That's seven damage.
All right. That one... Yeah, so McKenzie, you swing and barely miss. Like I said, he feels the air on the back of his neck. Seconds later, a knife whips by your ear, and you feel the wind. Because that's what your near crit gets you.
Sure. Yeah.
Is like, right. This is cinematic. And the knife, like, as he stands up, just the knife in the back of the neck, and he goes down for real.
Okay. And then I calmly walk up, pull the knife out, pull the other knife out, and... look at you and just like wipe it off on my sleeve. Put it away, wipe the other one off on my sleeve, and turn around and walk back. Like, what were you guys doing? Come on. Like, I murdered all three of these guys by myself. Oh, I'm going to stop and make sure that the other two dudes that went down are actually dead.
Yeah, they are. Okay. Because you didn't shoot.
I hit both of them. Yeah. And then I murdered
You murdered all three of them. You executed all three of them.
Would you like to make a sanity check, Colin?
I guess I have
to. Yeah.
What I got to do? What I got to roll?
And now he's probably intimidated as hell by
you. So get your D10s.
Okay.
I don't think anybody's not intimidated by me at this point.
And then your sanity score is there.
Right.
So you want to roll under that number.
Okay. Can't wait to roll over. Here we go. No, I didn't. I did it right. 67.
Right. I think
I'm still going to lose one for the... the trauma
for the brutal murdering in front of your eyes.
All right.
I mean, sheer badassery. But
you know. Sure.
And I mean, you've seen people die.
I've seen some stuff.
So this doesn't.
No, you haven't.
Yeah.
Not yet.
Not with you guys.
Not relative to the crew.
It's
that
coming.
You're running with.
Yeah, I haven't seen Hell's Maw open or whatever you guys have been through, but.
No, you don't understand. I was in the Philippines, and they didn't even have ice there. It was awful.
How do you eat Italian ice?
I grew up in New Zealand. What's ice?
So the way this kind of goes over, like, it's disturbing in that it had to go down that brutally. But, you know, they're enemy combatants. You've seen people get murdered and blown up in your time as a resistance against the fascists in Italy. So, you know, it's not the worst thing that's ever happened. You know, these guys were soldiers. They knew what was coming, but it's still the cost of three human lives that is, you know, that's going to weigh on you potentially in the future. So.
I assume the first knife went into his back, kind of centerish mass.
Like
something
between
that
the shoulder blade
could be covered with a backpack or a backpack.
Yeah.
Okay. Then we're still good.
Or a
cape.
The other two were taken out by the butt of the rifle. So.
Something jaunty.
Right. I'm hoping to have three.
Sure.
Yeah.
Three uniforms. Okay.
That are usable.
Okay. So three uniforms. One, you know, you'll need to replace the shirt, and I guess you don't need to wear his shirt. You'll need to replace the coat.
Yeah.
At some point, because it is bloodstained now, but your backpack will cover it temporarily.
Yeah. And when I get back to the guys, I just like start stripping the boots, like just not even worried about it. Take the boots off. Take the socks. Yank the pants. Like I'm. This is all business now. It's all business.
Yeah. So who's wearing the uniforms?
Not personal.
Business.
It's not
business.
Me. Not those you. Three.
Your size 13.
Yes, sir.
Morley or Haley needs to wear one of the uniforms.
So are we going in with two?
If you want three, there are six of you guys.
Right, right, right.
There are six British forces.
Sure.
Technically. So, and you have three Nazi uniforms.
Okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So you can have three prisoners, up to three prisoners. He's too big to fit into the uniforms.
I'd say the commander, Captain McKenzie, and then Haley or Morley. Yeah. And then you and I can go in.
As prisoners. Yeah, okay.
Cullen and I can go in as prisoners. What is your name? Levon?
Levon Fisk.
Monsieur Fisk.
What do you do with the other
Senor.
NPC that you aren't dressing up as a Nazi and have not yet labeled?
Hand him a sniper rifle and put him up in a tree watching the encampment.
Okay.
I mean, that way he can cover us on the way out. If things go badly.
Things go hairy, sure.
Where do you want him to be positioned?
Oh, things are going to go badly. We had a good tree.
You had a good tree that was observing the...
The T in the road.
The T in the road and the mobile camp. You want to put him in that tree?
That's too far away from
the... No, I want to put him in a tree near the base.
Okay. That's fair.
I thought we had a tree.
We had some trees there.
No, you had some hiding places, but climbing up to them was what Jack did over by the camp.
Then mobile camp. I'd rather put him in a tree near the base.
Okay.
So he can figure that out. I trust Morley to do his job correctly.
I trust what's his name.
Hey, look, I have names written down.
Sure.
So Morley is staying outside.
Yeah. And according to your little drawing here, probably a tree-ish here.
I'm
like
right
off the
here.
Road.
He's
yeah,
right
yeah,
here.
That's perfect. And give him, Jack, you've got the best sniper rifle.
Yeah, he can have my own field.
Yeah, give him the best option we have for sniping. Sure. And then, you know, tell him
and
if he sees us running,
yeah.
Shoot that
help.
I will also leave him with my Thompson. So in case things get really bad, he can pull that out and provide some cover fire.
Sure.
Okay.
I mean, it means he won't have to reload his whatever.
Yeah,
machine gun.
Right.
You've outfitted him with so.
Yeah.
Right,
but that way he can do
fair.
Suppression fire if
okay.
we need.
All right, so he's going to be camping in a tree. Awesome.
Sure. Maybe even two of the Tommy guns, so he doesn't have to reload. He can just.
Nah, I'd rather take Tommy guns in. The less we take in, the bad worse it's gonna get. I can already tell.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not saying we're going in to kill Nazis.
But we're going to kill some Nazis.
Because it should just go unsaid.
If Nazis don't get killed in this situation, I will be extremely surprised.
Well, I mean, I already killed
more Nazis don't get killed. I would be extremely surprised.
What was that?
People being helpful.
He asked for a pencil. They both grabbed the same one and handed it to him.
But then
it
got all
time.
Dainty all of a sudden.
It really did. It was lovely.
It's a Lady and the lovely. Tramp friendship move. I don't know what we'd call it, but.
All right. Well.
Yeah, so you're suited up as Nazis.
Well, some of us.
Right.
Others of us have decided not to sully ourselves with
right.
that.
I'm too much man.
You're a man of substance.
Let's be honest. Your hair was too greasy.
Racist.
Wow. We've been in the woods for like a week.
So you can tell your hair. It's going to be terrible after a week.
Wow. I'm going to assume one of you guys would make the idea roll, so I'm just going to offer this up. Do you have a cover story for capturing these prisoners? I know you said you've captured prisoners, but, like, what were they doing?
We found this guy.
Where
found
did you find him?
We found him sneaking around the woods.
Where?
I mean, I think we should probably stick as close to our actual story as possible.
Yeah, okay. Found them down by the road.
Okay, so
they're sniffing around
I'm
by
the. Their commander was wearing bloody underwear in the middle of the road.
It was weird.
So weird.
Kind of hot though.
Woken things in me.
So I'm just gonna run this by you one time because this is the story as I see it.
Sure.
The three of you in Nazi uniforms are pretending to be more soldiers sent in from the mobile camp. So you were sent in down the road, and somehow these two guys, an Italian and a mangled person, had snuck past the mobile camp on the road, and you encountered them between the base and the camp at the other end.
I'm sensing a note of skepticism about this plan.
I'm just making sure this is the plan you're going to put forth.
John, is this you saying, are you sure you want to go alone?
I'm not saying that at all.
Is this aided by the fact that we actually have been living in the woods for like the past 2 weeks?
What do you mean aided by the fact?
Well, because they do look like...
Sure, yeah, he does. They do look like they've been living in the woods for 2 weeks. Yeah.
Greasy.
Pizza's getting real cold.
I'm just saying... The nearest civilization is behind the camp, like where, and I'm just putting the plan out. Like,
yeah.
That's the story you're going to tell to the gate guards.
Yeah. My reaction is going to be, yeah.
Okay.
Just as surprised as you are. Okay. I don't know where these people came from.
That's why we brought them here to interrogate them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Duh.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Get the bamboo shoots ready.
Sure.
I mean, this base is run by SS, right? So, I mean, this would be the best place to take them.
Yeah.
SS do the best investigations.
SS is the bestest. Right?
I wouldn't say that. I would not say that. I'm not in a Nazi uniform.
Right.
I did not see that coming.
Oh, boom. All
right. So, you're free to approach the camp at your leisure. Is that what you're going to do?
Commander?
Yeah.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. So, we're going to jump right to that. You guys...
Let's just hope they don't notice our lack of paperwork.
They'll throw us off the Zeppelin.
Is it? Don't go pulling those threads. That's going to be dangerous.
Or the fact that we probably smell like we've been rolling in raccoon shit for the last 2 weeks.
Not all of us do that, Canadian.
That's moose shit, thank you very much.
Well, you make do with what you got.
Yeah, fair enough.
Yeah, sure.
So you guys approach the camp. Soldiers... marching behind the prisoners, and the gate guards, like, you know, fall out and come, you know, approach you with guns at the ready, but not violent.
Can I make a military doctrine roll to know the standard operating procedures for entering a German camp?
That is a fair.
You can try, yeah. Yeah, you can definitely make that roll, yeah.
And for the record, Jack, raccoons, new world animal. We wouldn't been rolling around in raccoon shit here. What?
28 out of 76.
Okay.
Squirrel?
Sure. Yeah.
Okay. Moose and squirrel?
Moose and squirrel.
That's bad. Moose and squirrel.
Yeah, so you wanted to know the protocol for approaching...
Yeah, yeah.
On foot with prisoners. Yeah, I mean, I don't know what it would be. I don't feel like it would be anything super special, but you successfully...
Well, I didn't know...
You know the secret handshake.
Well, it's a sort of thing I didn't know. Should I go up to the guard and talk? Should I walk up and stay 5 feet in front of the gate until the guard acknowledges me and comes to me?
Yeah,
should
I? So it's been a while since you've seen the drawing, but you might want to... So they have machine gun embankments. There's normally a wooden barricade... between these sandbag piles that they move out of the way for when trucks come and go. And then you have the two barbed wire gates that can open inward to allow vehicles to pass. So the guards that are behind the machine gun embankments come out to meet you.
Yeah.
They address you based on the insignia on your uniform.
Yeah.
Which is exactly like the... insignia that the three guys that you captured wore. Corporal, like what is this?
We have come from the mobile camp.
Yeah.
And they, as we were coming through here, we stumbled upon some European soldiers or British soldiers.
These are British?
Well, I think their uniforms are.
Nope, they're
no,
in
we
street
are not
clothes.
Universe.
Oh, okay. Well, I wish I'd remembered that.
It's all right. You can.
Yeah.
You would see that they are wearing British uniforms. That's
we came across these civilians.
Okay.
In the woods as we were.
Okay.
Coming through.
All right. So you call them civilians, not British soldiers.
Yeah.
Okay.
Or these people.
Sure.
These.
But you don't refer to them as spies?
No.
Okay.
Because we'd be dead on the spot.
Well, I just, yeah. I mean, they'd be like, so deal with them. Yeah.
I tried to, but I missed like three times. Kind of embarrassing.
Point blank, yeah. So they're like, so they question, they turn to the prisoners and they're like, who are you? Where are you? You know, what are you doing out here in the woods?
What language are they addressing them in?
German.
No, sprechen Sie Deutsch.
Okay. So you just tell them you don't speak German?
That's correct.
Da.
Da,
yeah.
It's Russian.
No. You don't understand. When I DM, or story keeper, when I'm the keeper, my Russian is all, or my German is all Russian.
Ah.
Okay. Anyway, he kind of like looks back at his fellows confused for a moment. And he says, open the gate, take them inside.
Right.
And so the guy that was talking to you basically falls in behind your prisoners, putting a row between you and them.
Yep.
And as you're walking, his fellows fall in behind you.
Okay.
So, the gate opens, they march you in.
Are we tied up?
Are they tied up?
I don't think so.
I think you probably would have tied us at least
our hands,
looking convincingly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What did you have?
Well, I'm assuming you're going to make that suggestion.
Yeah, I would have suggested that at least make it look like we're bound.
Okay.
It doesn't have to be actually tight or anything, as long as it looks good.
Okay. Somebody needs to make a field craft.
That's John's call.
So I can't tie them because I'm the one that's tied up.
Yeah.
I've got a knife.
Why would you
field craft?
What do you think you would use to tie someone up based on this list of?
Let's see. What's the highest number?
Yeah. Right.
First aid might be one.
Rope use.
There's a rope use skill.
Oh jeez.
There's a rope.
Yeah. Rope use skills right there.
Oh gosh.
Jesus.
10%.
I
bet none of us have.
Knowledge of knots. Knowledge.
Is there anything like taking a 20?
It seems like fieldcraft gets overused, but I think that's the only one that could possibly.
Using my cryptography, I've studied how to tie knots.
Yeah.
The Celtic knot code.
Yeah. It's in the edge of all the maps.
Sure.
Well, actually, during World War II,
I can throw a rope around your wrists.
Yeah.
So.
During World War II, there were actually people that would knit patterns that were secret codes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. They claim that they did it with slaves in the Underground Railroad too. That they would make quilts with maps.
Mm-hmm. I was just
made
reading
into them. Yeah.
I was reading an article the other day.
I've heard it's not necessarily. There's dispute whether that's true or not.
Survival also.
Survival. I like that one. Survival.
Sorry, I was looking for other skills that weren't rope use.
I appreciate
because
that.
Because rope use just means we're screwed.
Yeah. Survival. Somebody rolls. Somebody who's not getting tied up rolls.
I mean,
survival.
I could use survival on him.
You could. That's
so,
true.
If you like.
One of you.
I will continue to sit here and patiently wait.
I have a 1 for survival.
I have a 27.
I got under my 65.
Okay.
So you're
okay.
Tied up.
Can I watch him and then just do what he did?
You can.
Can he instruct him how to do it?
So yeah, you get a plus 20.
Okay.
On your attempt.
So that brings me up to a 47.
Yeah, that's almost.
And that's a 96.
Not great.
And I'm just like,
could have been better.
You really, you actually tied me here? This is not what we were going for.
Well, you know, with the heels and the robe, I just thought it was appropriate.
Anyway.
No.
So I'm going to say that he does a job that you are going to have to make a dex check to get out of.
Oh, great.
When you go, you're like, yeah, that looks right. And then if you get to the point where you're going to try to break out of them, it will require a check.
I like how the murder guy is the one that's tied up actually well.
Yeah. So, but LeVar, you are.
LeVon. LeVar. Mr. Burton.
Yeah.
That's right.
You are free to remove your restraints
right.
at your convenience,
right.
Assuming you get to that point.
Right.
Oh, right. There's my pages. All right. So you get escorted in. The two prisoners are taken to what you identified as the main building before. Mm-hmm. And the three dressed up as the Nazis are taken to not where you believed the soldiers were being bunked down at, but a like another command area.
Okay.
Okay. I'm trying to just decide which scene. Yeah, we'll go with the soldiers first.
And, you know, actually, that's a great place for us to take a break.
Okay.
We, of course, have other podcasts. You can find those all over at nerdsdom.com. And otherwise, we will talk to you guys next week.
And that will do it for us tonight on the Nerds Domain Presents Masks of Nyarlathotep. Remember, you can email us at nerdsdomain@gmail.com or find us over on Facebook and Twitter at facebook.com/nerdsdomain and twitter.com/nerdsdomain. You can also check out our site at nerdsdom.com. Be sure to sign up for our newsletter while you're there. You can head over to iTunes and give us a 5-star rating. We want to thank Passion Nerdly for our music. Don't forget, you can support us at patreon.com/nerdsdomain and check out our shirts at tpublic.com.